Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2181, List Folder Files in Excel. Hey, welcome back to Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question, someone has a list of tax invoice PDF files in a folder, and they need to get the list of all those file names in Excel, all right? And one way to do that is to, type them all or copy and paste from Windows Explorer. But there's a great tool that can solve this. And my first question was, well, what version of Excel do you have? Because if you happen to have Excel 2016, you're going to have this amazing new functionality called Get and Transform Data. Now, in Office 365, it's on the left-hand side. I think in the original version of Excel 2016, it was in the third group. All right, so just look for Get and Transform. If you're in Excel 2010 or Excel 2013 for Windows, you can download Power Query, and you'll have your own tab with this exact stuff. Now, let's take a quick look at this folder. All right, I just created a fake folder here with some fake data. You'll see that there are Excel files in this folder and PDFs. I only want the PDFs, and there's also some subfolder. I don't want these PDFs. I only want the PDFs in the main folder. So C colon budgets. I'm going to copy that and then come back here to Excel, and we're going to say that we want to get data from a file from an entire folder like this, and then type the folder path in there or use the browse button, either one. And when you get this first screen, you definitely want to edit. And now we're in the Power Query Editor. All right, so my goal here, I don't need the content, so I'm going to right click and say remove that column. There's my list of files. I only want PDF files, so if there's anything that's not a PDF, I only want PDFs. Click OK. That gets us just the PDF files. Oh, and then look over here. See, now they're pulling in things from just the original folder and from the garbage folder. So I open this up and I uncheck everything that's not the original folder. All right, so now I have a nice little list, and this list is, you know what, 9 records, but in real life, I bet they probably have, you know, dozens or hundreds of these. All right, I don't need any of this other stuff now, so I can right click and remove those columns. All right, now what I really need here is I need the folder path and the file name together. All right, so I'm going to take folder path and drag it to the left and drop it there. And then the magic step here, in a regular Excel, we would have to do concatenation for this. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to merge columns. So I'm going to add column and choose merge columns. The separator is going to be none. The new column is going to be called file name, and click OK. All right, so we have the folder name, the slash, and the file name like that. Now that's actually the only thing we need. So I'm going to right click and say remove the other columns. And then finally, home, close and load. And we get a brand new sheet with our data. All right, now it comes in as a table. And so I'm going to just copy this, Control C, and then come over here to where I really wanted the data to appear and paste special values. Click OK. Now it's not a table anymore, it's just my pure data like that. And now here's the really beautiful thing about this. So we set this up once, and wow, that took less than 3 minutes to set up. But let's come back to that budgets folder and let's move some stuff around. Let's take one of these garbage records and we'll copy it up to the main folder, Control V. All right, so now there's more stuff here. There's 10 PDF files instead of 9. If I come here to where the query is, and over on the right hand side of the screen in the queries and connections, you might have to make this wider. I've made mine wider already. You'll see our budgets with 9 rows loaded. I'm going to click the little refresh icon here, and very quickly, budgets now has 10 rows loaded. So it's picking up the new records. You set this up once, and then you'll be able to just refresh to get the new data. Well, this is the point in the podcast where I usually ask you to buy my book, but instead today I'm going to ask you to buy this book, M is for Data Monkey by Ken Puls and Miguel Escobar, an amazing book that will teach you all about using Power Query or the Get and Transform Data. Everything I learned about Power Query, I learned from this book. Okay, wrap up from this episode. Our goal is how to import a list of file names into Excel. If you have Excel 2016, you can use the new Get and Transform Data. If you don't have 2016, but you have a real version of Excel, Excel running under Windows, then you can download the free Power Query add-in. That's for Excel 2010 or Excel 2013. It's not going to work on your Android phone or your iPad or your iPhone or Surface RT or your Mac, right? It's only for Windows versions of Excel. So we're going to start from blank worksheet, data, get data from file, from folder, enter the folder name or browse. Make sure to click edit instead of load. and then on the filter, our filter on the file type to get rid of anything that's not a PDF, filter on the folder name to get rid of all the garbage subfolders, keep only the file name and folder, so right click those others and say remove column, then drag the folder heading to the left of file, that allows the merge to work, select both columns, then on the add column tab, choose merge columns, type a new name, click OK, and then click on that, right click on that new column and remove the other columns, home, close and load, and it will give you your list. The amazing part, you can refresh the query later by using this refresh icon over in the queries and connections. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.